morning all. In today's lecture, we are going to learn Kirchhoff's voltage law. Before proceeding further, in last lecture I told you to understand the concept of Kirchhoff's voltage law, you have to remember four important sign conventions. Am I right? Can you just recollect all those four sign conventions that we had studied in last lecture? The first sign convention was, if we go from positive terminal of the battery to the negative terminal of the battery or source. If we go from positive terminal of the battery to the negative terminal of the battery or source, there will be fall in potential and the EMF assign is always negative. Am I right? What was the second sign convention? Yes, as per the second sign convention, if we go from negative terminal of the battery to the positive terminal of the battery or source, there will be rise in potential and the EMF assign is always positive. The third sign convention says that if the direction of the current and the polarity assigned to the resistor both are in same direction, so there will be fall in potential and the voltage drop across that particular resistor is given by V is equal to minus I into R. Am I right? The last sign convention says that if the direction of the current and the polarity assigned to the resistor both are in opposite direction, so there will be rise in potential and the voltage drop across that particular resistor is given by V is equal to plus I into R. In this particular circuit, you need to apply Kirchhoff's voltage law with the help of four sign conventions. Let's begin with the first sign convention. Please pay attention over here. Now, in this circuit, let's consider current flowing in this circuit is I1. What you need to do? First, you have to assign the current direction in clockwise direction. Okay? So, let's consider current flowing in this particular circuit is I1. Now, by default, this is the lower potential. So, you need to assign negative sign for that. This is the higher potential. You need to assign positive sign for that. Am I right? Now, next, what you need to do? You have to assign the polarities to the resistors. Am I right? So, how you are going to assign the polarities? According to the direction of current. As I have considered clockwise direction, so according to this clockwise direction, the first polarity will be plus, next would be minus. Similarly, this would be plus, next would be minus, and same on. Okay? Now, next, what you need to do? Now, you have to apply Kirchhoff's voltage law for this particular circuit. Let's begin with second sign convention. Now, as you can observe over here, if we go from negative terminal of the battery to the positive terminal of the battery or source, there will be rise in potential and that EMF is equal to positive. So, here the EMF value is what? V1. So, you need to consider positive V1. I hope you have understood the second sign convention. Now, which sign convention you are going to apply over here? Now, the direction of the current and the polarity assigned to the resistor both are in same direction. If they are in same direction, what you need to do? You have to consider voltage drop across this particular resistor is equal to what? Minus I into R. Am I right? So, just write down minus sign over there. I. What is I? Current flowing through that circuit. Now, can you tell me in this circuit which current is flowing? I1 current. And instead of R, which resistor is over there? R1. Again, here you have to apply what? Again, you need to apply third sign convention. If the direction of the current and the polarity assigned to the resistor both are in same direction, then there will be fall in potential and the voltage drop across that particular resistor is given by minus I into R. So, this would be equal to minus I1 into R2. Now, what is Kirchhoff's voltage law? The algebraic sum of electromotive forces and the voltage drop across each and every resistor is equal to zero. So, what is the statement form? The algebraic sum of all the voltages is equal to zero around a closed loop. So this should be equal to zero. I hope you have understood how to apply Kirchhoff's voltage law in the circuit. In next lecture, we are going to solve problem based on Kirchhoff's current law and Kirchhoff's voltage law. Thank you.